The Xbox One! You know that thing that I've been completely harping on the past few weeks? And then they changed their policy and I didn't really have a legitimate reason to gripe about it anymore? Well, guess what? If you're one of those people that likes being fucked up the ass with DRM and checking in at least once every 24 hours, there's a petition online for you. In fact, there are several. I'm speaking, of course, about the several petitions that have been going around online recently, wanting the original Xbox One, rules to come back, more like laws. So, Microsoft gets rid of all that stuff that, you know, everybody was complaining about, well, except for the whole privacy issue with the Kinect. Other than that, the majority of it was gone. And the consumer was like, yeah, now I can pre-order one. And even myself, I thought, okay, now the Xbox One is a legitimate choice for me to purchase somewhere down the road. And then Microsoft fanboys, in their infinite wisdom, think that it is best for the Xbox One to go back to its previously proposed policies. I'm just going to read off one of these petitions in particular. There are several floating around the internet right now, which is one of the reasons why I don't think it's like this. I don't think it's an isolated trolling incident. These things are all over the internet at this point. They claim, and this is a quote, because they have bad grammar. I don't want this to be a representative of my speaking ability, or spelling ability, or proofreading ability. We want back the features that the trolls of the internet has complained away. Trolls of the internet did not complain away the DRM policy, the always checking in. That was the consumer that got rid of that. It was the pre-order figures that Microsoft was getting back, so saying, oh shit, we're being kicked, our asses are being handed to us 3-1 in pre-orders. Alright, this is a pretty big gap. So, Microsoft did what any sane company would do and changed their policies. After, of course, they had said at E3 that there is no off switch, that, you know, we can't just turn it off. They hit the off switch and turn it off, which raised another concern with me of if you have an off switch, then there's an on switch. So, they want discless playing from disc games. Okay. Sure. Because piracy, how do you control it? We want family game sharing. Okay, I can understand that. That's a legitimate demand. I mean, Sony already has that with their consoles. We want access to play our games on any Xbox One console. You know, it's starting to sound like it's not so much like a troll petition at all. We want a console of the future, not an Xbox 360 on steroids. Well, that's kind of what you're getting. We don't care if we have to check in online once every 24 hours. You're probably also a few of those people who like it that the NSA is violating your rights to privacy and how they're just able to spy on you whenever you feel like it. You know, you guys are probably like, well, if I'm not doing anything wrong, then what's the problem? But thanks for making it region-free. We don't want to change that. You people, beep, 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 are probably one of the biggest reasons why I do not like gamers. I really don't. The fanboys like this that want Microsoft to bend them over and assert their genitalia into their anuses. I don't get it. I really don't. How could any sane person go, I want restrictions on my games. I don't want the ability to play them whenever I want. Well, you know, if the servers go down, well, fuck me. Now my Xbox One's a paperweight. That's... I don't get it. I really don't. You want an always-on console. You want a console that doesn't require a disc to play. So, essentially what you're wanting is a digital download, which Microsoft has proven in the past that they can just hit an off switch on that digital download, and you'll never be able to play that game again, therefore wasting your $60. You'll never get that back. They have the right to shut down multiplayer servers without any notice whatsoever. In fact, if they really wanted to, as per... They won't do this, mind you, at least I don't think they would. But as per the license agreement with Microsoft, they could shut down everything for the 360 and Xbox One, essentially doing this to you, and because you hit the yes button, you have no legal recourse. You want that. That is what I am gathering from these petitions. You want to be controlled. You're the consumer. You're supposed to vote with your dollar. You're supposed to control with your dollar. You're not supposed to get... It's like a bully coming up to you and demanding your lunch money. You give it to him. Yeah, he gets to go have lunch. What do you have in the end? An empty stomach, and it's growling. And then you gotta make your way up to 6th period world history. And then you're gonna be bitching in world history because you didn't get a fucking turkey sandwich for lunch. That is exactly what you people are. That's what you are. And that's what you will be if you let Microsoft bully you into submission. I honestly can't believe that after all of that.
And then the trolls of the internet complained it away.
Yes, because the trolls of the internet... The trolls of the internet don't give a shit about the Xbox One. They've already pre-ordered a PlayStation 4, or they're part of the PC Nathwraith. They don't give a shit about the Xbox One. In fact, I know of no person that gives a shit about the Xbox One. I know of one person who's going to be purchasing an Xbox One, and he told me that the only reason why he wanted to purchase one is so that way he could see what the DRM was like and then promptly get rid of it. Nobody wants this console in the first place. And it's already got a bad reputation as it is. 771 supporters, you still need about a little over 9K before you can even get recognized by any legitimate source. Good luck with that. You probably won't even make it past 5. Fucking stupid people, man. Console war my ass. If it's a war, then the Xbox One has already failed right out of the gate. And this actually brings up, now that I'm talking about the Xbox One, there's another thing that Xbox fanboys have been going on about recently, and that's this rumor that they're going to upgrade the Xbox One to 12 gigs of RAM and put an even better processor in it. Probably not. Here's why. Those consoles are already in a factory somewhere, being assembled, getting ready for the holiday season. It's July, all right? Not mid-July, but it's past the first week of July. We're in the second week. That thing comes out in November. They're in a factory somewhere getting built. They're not going to stop. They're not going to discard the millions of units they've already manufactured to upgrade the RAM or the processor for the Xbox One. I could see this happening 3 years down the line, have an Xbox One Plus, and have it be an upgraded piece of hardware, but it's not going to happen anytime soon. Don't get your hopes up. I would have brought this up in a Pwncast, but obviously there's no Pwncast this week. If you're one of these people that are around on the internet that think that DRM on the Xbox One is a great idea and thinks that digital downloads is the way of the future, getting rid of all physical media, checking in once every 24 hours at least, and, DRM, let me know. I really want to know what is motivating you to buy this console. Especially if you want these policies back. I want you in the comment section to convince me, or attempt to convince me, to cancel my PlayStation 4 pre-order and switch it over to an Xbox One pre-order. I want you people to try to do that in the comments below. Until then, I've got a lot of stuff to do. I gotta get ready for work. Phantasm Mask here, signing out.